Introducing first, from Providence, Rhode Island, weighing 240 pounds, Pete Pompey. First, I'd like to introduce the manager, Luscious Johnny Valiant. Oh, yeah! Now introducing, weighing 270 pounds, the Spoiler.
There he is, the Spoiler, along with manager Luscious Johnny Valiant, going against Pete Pompey, the referee for this bout. Right now, the match getting underway with the Spoiler potting away on Pete Pompey. Valiant out of the ring. Luscious Johnny, both men going at it.
And I'll tell you something, Jack, there's no referee.
My goodness, you're right, Jesse.
The Spoiler uses the ropes. I'll tell you, the Spoiler is an expert at the ropes. Picking up Pete Pompey and again taking him over to the ropes. And look at Luscious Johnny taking pictures on the sideline.
Referee Roger Francoeur right now pulling both men apart, the Spoiler and Pete Pompey, the Spoiler in command of this bout right now.
And look Jack, Luscious Johnny, yeah, taking pictures. He's taking pictures from ringside as the Spoiler's working Pete Pompey over. Look at Luscious Johnny. Got him. Pompey pushing the Spoiler in the corner and going for some shoulder blocks. Collar elbow hookup. Spoiler goes to a top wrist lock. Reversed into a hammer lock by Pete Pompey.
You're gonna wind up with NBC News, you got in my way.
Johnny Valiant complaining bitterly at ringside as he's running around with a camera. Very expensive looking camera, and looks to be taking pictures of the Spoiler. Look at him hollering at referee Roger Francoeur.
He wants him to get out of the way, Jack, because he's impeding him taking pictures of the Spoiler. They're obviously not taking Pete Pompey too serious. The Spoiler with a reverse chin lock on him, standing behind him, stretching the neck out right now. There you can see Luscious is still taking pictures. Into the ropes, Pompey ducks the elbow, but gets caught by a clothesline and down he goes. And a big elbow to the side of the neck. Spoiler picks him up, and there goes the claw. This may be it, Jack. The Spoiler's putting the claw in. Look at Luscious Johnny taking pictures.
He loves it. He loves it. Right on top of all the action, along with our World Wrestling Federation cameras.
Get out of my way!
Valiant calling the shots as the Spoiler continues his assault. Wait a minute. Referee Roger Francoeur has called for the bell.
He got the three count. The Spoiler put the claw on and Pompey's shoulders, went to the mat for a three count. And the Spoiler's refusing to break the hold, giving that little added dimension of pain.
Right now, Valiant, look at that. Valiant taking a picture of referee Francoeur. There's the Spoiler. Boy, you talk about action. You talk about confusion.
Well, I'll tell you, Jack, that's one of the strangest matches I've ever seen.
Right now, let's go to the ring.
The winner of the match, the Spoiler.
There's your winner, the Spoiler, along with this very, very happy manager, Luscious Johnny Valiant.
Now you see the Spoiler drop the big elbow on him, and it's now setting him up for his claw. There goes the claw hold. Now here's what you missed, Jack. When he puts the claw on, you'll see Pete Pompey's shoulders go down to the mat if we have time, and the referee called the three count.
Fans, stay tuned.
Size on the opposite side, it'll be Johnny Rodz. Rodz, the crafty veteran. Wyndham, Rotundo have really been coming into their own as of late. Would you agree with that, Bruno Sammartino?
I'll tell you, I am really, really impressed with Rotundo and Barry.
They are really proving themselves to be great champions, but so exciting to watch. Always love so much action, so much speed, stamina, you name it, and they got it. They're very, very impressive.
Nice single leg dive by Johnny Rodz. Spins over him, takes him down, stays behind him now, drives him, and Johnny Rodz under hook over now, and look it up and over by Barry Windham. Rodz now backing off. Rodz will accept that he was busted by Barry Windham.
It was simply outmaneuvered by Windham. Windham showed a little bit of his amateur skills with kind of scrambling out there at the bottom and taking a hammerlock on Johnny.
And Johnny Rodz takes him over, covers him now, not for long. Barry Windham turning right into his man, up on his feet. Oh, my! Windham, that long, light body, he can really pack a punch, they say. Oh, my! Johnny Rodz, uppercut. Johnny Rodz with a little right hand. Right into the foot. And the target is made. Mike Rotundo comes in, hammers away on Rodz. Rodz now off the rope, elbow stretching. Rotundo, former Syracuse All-American now, takes Johnny Rodz over down to the canvas. Rotundo tightening the grip a bit, looking up at his tag team partner, no doubt. They are always watching each other as best as possible, listening for, what's going on here? Lombardi getting a little overzealous. The tag team partner, Johnny Rodz. Nice maneuver by Rodz. Mike Rotundo spinning into him. Rodz takes him over. Rodz staying right down. Now it's Rotundo behind Rodz. Quick tag made. Here comes Barry Windham by way of the top rope. And winds up Johnny Rodz. And Barry, tag made again. Here comes Mike Rotundo. Down across the arm. And you know, Johnny Rodz would like nothing better than to tag his partner finally over to make the tag. Double team effort, however. Tag is made now as Mike Rotundo comes in. Mike Rotundo with Lombardi, whipped to the ropes and off Lombardi, up in the air. Airplane spin, just about the fastest one you'll ever see. Drop to the canvas, hook the leg, roughly with one, two, left side of three. All right, what a victory. Here they go, they're not finished yet. Just with a right hand, but you can bet that Mike Rotundo and Barry Windham are looking better than ever.
Here are your winners, the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, Barry Windham and Mike Rotundo.
Supporting
through garbage. In just a few moments, you're looking right here at prime time, the elite of wrestling. In just a few moments, you're about to see a match that stole, that where the champion, so-called Hulk Hogan, stole the title. Couldn't beat me, couldn't do nothing. So he brings in with this guy, Mr. T. Yeah. The guy that wears all that gold that he stole from down the street. The only guy that I know that runs around, the guy that runs around with that stupid haircut. I've never seen nothing like that in my life. This goofball wants to come in, and all of a sudden these two have made a challenge. The T and Mr. T, we're supposed to call him Mr. You ribbon me. T and Hogan, they want to take on the both of us. All of a sudden they think that they're big time, but he didn't look too big time when we dropped him like that piece of...
He didn't look so bad, did he, Rod?
He didn't look bad enough.
He didn't look very tough, did he?
The haircut looked bad.
Yeah, maybe all to the little kitties, maybe to all the little porch monkeys out there, he looks bad.
Yeah, but now, gosh, you see, so you guys, you know the tall blonde one that claims to be the champion?
Duh.
And you know the shorter black fella with the kind of funny haircut. That's the one. You wanna get in there, brother, and you wanna try some fighting, huh? Then let me tell you something. You get together, you form yourself a team, because you're looking at someone that ain't a scared of nobody at no time. You're stupid enough to come in there. We accept your challenge. We accept your challenge. Only one place, man. We
We want to fight you right in the garden where my belt belongs. We want to fight you right where we left them laying all over. I love the way you tip Cindy Lauper's hat. I want you people to look at this.
I'm going to tell you why. She is so ugly. She is so ugly that I feel sorry for the woman.
Last yesterday, she was suntanny vulture started circling her. Huh? Are you kidding me? You come on down, T. We'll put a hex where the keys should be. You're looking at fine.
Fans in the World Wrestling Federation.
Well, it certainly doesn't look to me like this is the most energetic of workouts for Cowboy Bob Orton, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorf, and Rowdy Roddy Piper in preparation for their big upcoming match. Gentlemen, I don't know if I can get any insight. Spent here. What is going on here, Cowboy Bob?
Deep in thought, Daddy. Meditation. You don't bother them while they're thinking about how they're going to rip Hogan and Mr. T apart. You see, when the time's right, they'll get up and commence to working out. Right now, they're deep in thought, deep meditation, you see, getting psychologically ready to destroy two geeks.
Well, that, of course, is your opinion. You're virtually out of the action, Bob Orton, with that broken left forearm. Yes. Rowdy Roddy Piper, a man never lost for words. I'm wondering if I can get down here. Mr. Piper, could I prevail upon you, sir, for any comments regarding just exactly what... What in the world? What's going on here? What are you doing? The reporter's on being psychopathic the way this man is handling this thing. Roddy Piper, what in God's name are you doing? Paul Orndorf. Please, Paul Orndorf. Ladies and gentlemen, I... Please, is this it? Time's up? All right. Piper. Roddy Piper.
What you want, man?
What?
What you want coming in here barging about us, man? What you want, huh? What you want?
What
are you going to ask? I'm going to beat up some geek with hair cut down the sides, huh?
What do you mean, what am I doing here?
This is private. This has nothing to do with you.
This is my job.
This has nothing to do with you.
Well, you got a lousy job, mister. You got a lousy job. Almost as lousy as we do. Got to touch all that guck and grime and slime, man.
It's not one thing to get in the ring with Hogan and Mr. T. The black scummy.
Oh, please, what kind of talk is that?
It's street talk, that's what it is.
Street talk?
It's trash talk.
This is wrestling.
And that's exactly what we're getting in the ring with. Trash.
I don't know what we've been able to accomplish here, but I will say this, ladies and gentlemen. It seems that there is much mental meditation and thought going into the preparation on the part of Rowdy Roddy Piper, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorf, and the big match coming up WrestleMania with Hulk Hogan and Mr. T. I'm going to scoot out of here and out into the other room, if I may. This looks a little bit more like it, the physical aspect of a big tag team bout like the one coming up as part of WrestleMania. Paul Orndorf, obviously, with a
little... lost.
Why does he talk to me like that?
Oakland is supposed to be a closed workout, you understand?
What do you mean a closed workout?
Just what I told you. You're not supposed to be here. You see, we're getting psyched and getting ready for something that's very, very important to us. And what you're doing is you're breaking the concentration. Look at Paul Orndorf, Mr. Wonderful. Pop it, baby, pop it. Mr. T, get ready, Paul.
What are you doing here?
Mike, you're in business, man.
Mike, why is it? Listen. What the? I've got to say, I'm very impressed.
He's impressed. You're impressed. Who cares? I guess you would be impressed. I guess the whole world's impressed.
We told you not to come.
Hey, wait a minute.
We told you not to come.
Hey, give me a break here, gentlemen.
Yeah, we'll break something.
Yeah. Please, you're not going to physically intimidate me. Don't think you will.
We told you not to come.
Hey, help! Hey, what's that? Please, leave him alone! What? Come on, please! Chief! Leave him alone! God, Piper, this is disgusting! Oh! Are you all right?
Who's the contestants?
Update this week concerns the Giant. Could March the 31st be his last match ever? I'll explain that later. First, let us look at the Giant in a rare and unusual mood.
Bobby Heenan said that?
Bobby Heenan, Ken Patera, they all state that you should put up something, and they think that's the only fair thing for you to put up. That if you can't slam Big John Studd, then you retire from wrestling. If you do slam stud, of course, you don't retire,
You win that $10,000?
Win the $15,000. But don't you think you should put up something, Andre?
I don't think so.
Okay, but there are going to be people that state that there's a bit of yellow streak running down your back if you don't put it up. If you don't put something up, there are going to be people that state that there is a big yellow.
I'm going to tell you one thing. Nobody can be yellow, and I'm going to take that slam, and I'm going to take that $15,000, and I'm going to walk under it.
In the ring at this time...